Next question comes from Thomas Sains, who's asked, can you talk about how injection angle can be used when under vacuum and when under boost? Yeah, absolutely. So injection angle defines simply whereabouts in the engine cycle the fuel is being delivered. Now, this works for both port and direct injected engines. It's much more sensitive to a direct injected engine where our injection window basically is the start of the intake cycle through to a little bit before the ignition event occurs. So a little bit less than half of our complete engine cycle. With a port injected engine, we can inject literally 100% of the time. Not recommended, but we can do that. And when the intake valves are closed, we're simply injecting fuel against a closed valve where the fuel will be ingested into the engine the next time the intake valve opens. So with this in mind, the injection timing for a port injected engine is a lot more sensitive around the cruise, light up, low RPM, light load than it is at wide open throttle, because at high RPM and wide open throttle, it's quite likely our injector duty cycle might be 75 to 85%, meaning that basically the injector is open almost all the time anyway. And hopefully you can understand that if it's open almost the entire engine cycle, moving it around isn't going to make much difference. So how do we test and find the optimal air fuel ratio, the optimal injection timing? Well, it depends what our aims are. For OE manufacturers, this really comes down to emissions. So they'll be using a five gas analyzer and looking at the tailpipe emissions as they vary the injection timing. Now that might not always give us the best results in terms of power, torque, or fuel economy. For me, when I'm tuning the injection timing in vacuum, really what I want to do is get good fuel economy. So what we can do is one of two things. We can vary the injection timing until we either see the peak torque number occur, or alternatively, we'll quite often see that the torque number doesn't change, but as we vary the injection timing, our air fuel ratio will move richer, meaning that we're actually combusting more of the fuel that's being injected, and then we can remove fuel numbers from the table to get back to our target air fuel ratio. Long-winded answer there is basically we're getting the same amount of torque with a little bit less fuel being delivered. Essentially in boost, we're doing the same thing there as well. We're just looking at what injection angle gives us the best use of our fuel or maximum torque. That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.